This video is about the ToDo app which manages your tasks. Earlier we had Outlook. Outlook had a task folder. It is still there, but going forward, Microsoft is making the ToDo app like an aggregator which combines tasks across multiple apps. So ToDo is a very important app to understand. It's available on browser as well as Android and iOS. Works on tablet as well. Essentially, it's a browser-based app. If you have the new version of Outlook, it also shows the ToDo icon right next to the task folder. As you go along, you'll understand the difference between task folder and ToDo app, but the focus of today's video is the ToDo app. Let's say you have installed the ToDo app. Now, the first thing to do is log in using a corporate or Microsoft 365 ID and then go to settings. Once you go to settings, scroll down, you will see something called smart lists. Make sure you enable all the smart lists. We'll cover all of them later, but make sure everything is enabled. Down below, you will see connected apps. Enable planner and flagged email. Why? Because we have been flagging emails as though that was a task. But now this is a more formal task application. Now onwards, you should add tasks as tasks and not flag emails. But whatever is already flagged, we don't want to forget. They're implicit tasks. That's why we want to see it in ToDo app. Planner is shared task list, which is typically added in channels. Alright, now when you come back, you'll see a long list of items, my day, all the way up to tasks. We'll see those one by one. But let's start simple. Broadly, what I want to do, I want to manage my work and I also want to manage delegation. There is a third category under my work. My work is something I decide and I execute. Okay, I'll list it out and do it. But there are tasks coming to me from loop components or from meetings and from planners in channels. I also want them to be consolidated. That is also the job of ToDo. So tasks for me and tasks I give to others, two categories. Now, how do I add tasks for myself? That's the simplest, easiest way to use ToDo. Create a new list, add a task. Now, remember, when you create a new list, by default, you are the owner. You can create a shared task list. So if you have three people who you work with closely, whether they are colleagues or assistant, you should add them to the list. And then once you have more than one person in the list, you also have an assign to option. So you can do a mini delegation here itself. Now you will see if I create a shared task list, I can do the same thing in planner. Planner works independently as well as in channels. So what is the difference? So planner is a more evolved task management system. This one has very few fields, whereas planner has priorities. It has subtasks, it has color coding, it has categories, various types of filter and grouping, and planner tasks give you reminders. So all that is not available in tasks. This task is, ToDo is a simplistic task management. Planner is a more evolved shared task list. And if you want to go one more level up with linked tasks and resource management and Gantt charts, then there is MS Project. We have a planner best practices video. Have a look at that as well. If you use tasks in Outlook, those will appear in the task section of ToDo. Now in Outlook also you have delegation, so tasks which you have given to yourself and tasks others have given to you, both of them will appear in the task folder inside ToDo. The task list which you have created in ToDo, they have to be managed separately. They will not appear under tasks there. Now let's talk about groups. Yes, you can create independent lists, but you can group them in some categories. So maybe you have a project going on and you are coordinating with five different people. So you have created five shared task lists. And those you want to put in a group called Project X. So it gives you a little bit of organizational capability. The important thing to understand about ToDo is, yes, it is a task list management system, but it is also a very good way to create checklists. You may have shopping lists, travel lists, technical lists. Whenever you create a checklist and you complete it and you want to reuse the checklist, there is always a problem. I have to uncheck all the boxes. So in this case, what do? You duplicate the checklist and say, do not carry forward the completion status and delete the original one. That's how you reuse a checklist. Now let's look at the other components of ToDo. We have tasks which come from Outlook, I already told you. Flagged emails also come from Outlook. Whatever flagged emails you have, you continue to manage them, but don't create new flagged emails. Why? Because they should become tasks. Either you make the task in Outlook or ToDo, up to you, but don't flag those emails. In fact, when you're reading an email on Outlook mobile app, there is an option called Create a Task, which directly comes into your task folder, which is good. Then you will see another section called Assigned to Me. That's very interesting. Assigned to me from where? The simple generic answer is anywhere except Outlook. There are two places where people can assign tasks to you. One is Planner, which is a shared task list typically used in project management, and it sits inside a team. The second place is Loop Tasks. Loop tasks can be added to Teams chat, email, Word, and many other places, including Loop Workspace. So anyone assigning tasks to you from any of these two sources will land up in the Assigned to Me area. So in simple practical terms, if I want to know what is my pending work, you go to the ToDo app, all your pending work is there. Now potentially, where is it? One is in tasks, which is coming from Outlook. One is in the task list you have created yourself. One is assigned to me, and fourth is flagged email. Now I know this is still confusing. That's why there is a category called all, which gives you all of them together grouped by the source. There is one more category called plan. Section is not very important. Then any task you can mark or star or put an asterisk there saying, oh, this is important to me. So important tasks across places will be visible under important. It's like a mini filter. And finally, we have my day. Now, what does my day do? Well, it is your way of planning. What are you going to do today? So you can go to any task across all these categories and say, add to my day. Of course, you'll see the list. You execute it. If you don't do it also, no problem. It will carry forward to tomorrow. There's one more nice setting which says anything which is a task which is anyway due today, automatically add to my day. So that way you get visibility of the task. Now, before we finish, couple of settings you should know. Go to settings, recognize dates and times, and separate out or remove dates and times. What does that mean? If I say the task name and then I say space in 2 days, it understands it's 2 days. It calculates the due date and then automatically puts the due date and removes the word 2 days from the task. That's what it means. Very useful feature to have. Keep it on. So to summarize, install ToDo app on mobile. Get used to using it correctly. Initially, it may be a little confusing, but I've told you component by component what is the purpose of each one. Use it to your advantage and then you will understand how the aggregator capability of the ToDo app is going to help you in getting a single unified view of your pending work, and of course it'll help you execute the work in a timely manner. If you want me to show you a comparison between different task management systems inside Microsoft platform, which basically includes Outlook, Loop Components, Planner and ToDo, let me know in the comments. I'll be happy to create a comparison video as well. But in the meantime, I have a task management video which is very popular. Have a look at that. And a lot of work happens in Teams and a lot of action items get generated in Teams. So how to use Loop Components task list in Teams meetings is another video. Have a look at that as well. So that's it for now. Thank you.